Joining us on the line now from Dinagat Island is Akbayan Representative Kaka Bagao. Congresswoman Bagao, good evening and thanks for joining us tonight.
Hello, good evening from Dinagat Island.
Now, here's a question. When did you decide to run as representative of Dinagat Island?
Actually, I had a hard time deciding. A lot of people convinced me to consider running, especially when the speaker appointed me as caretaker of the Dinagat province. So it wasn't really a difficult decision, although it took me a long time. I have been working with a lot of communities in Dinagat Island even before I was appointed as caretaker. When I became a congresswoman, a representative of Akbayan party list, I have already been working with a lot of communities in Dinagat. So I think it was a logical situation for a lot of people who know me and for a lot of citizens in the province.
I'm sorry, Congressman, but I think the line was kind of choppy when I asked you the question. My question was, when did you decide to run for representative of Dinagat?
I think my decision came immediately before the last day of the filing of our certificate of candidacy. And that was after I was appointed as caretaker of the province.
Right. So you were appointed maybe that was 4 months, 5 months into the appointment. I'm sorry, you decided maybe 5 months into the appointment, correct?
My appointment came in before October, and I think the last day for the filing was October 5.
Mm-hmm.
But the speaker was already talking to me about it. Some congressmen already discussed the possibility and the idea of my being appointed as caretaker even before deciding to run came.
Mm-hmm. Now, when you decided to run, didn't you feel that this was going to cause you some conflict? Because you have been appointed caretaker, the funds have been released to you, and now you're deciding to run as representative of Dinagat Island.
No, I would just like to emphasize a point. My running for the elections next year, I think, is incidental to my being appointed. First, the money that was released by the government for the projects and the services for the province are not mine. These are monies that are dedicated for infrastructure programs, for medical assistance programs, for scholarship programs to citizens of Dinagat and not to my candidacy. So I cannot understand why, and it's sad that people are connecting my work and what I did for the province of caretaker to my running next year for the midterm election.
I'm sorry, you don't understand why people are connecting you being a caretaker in the province and you're running?
I think it's unfortunate that people are connecting the election to the delivery of the services that we are doing to the province because of my being appointed as caretaker. My task primarily as caretaker is to make sure that the people get the benefit that they deserve. They have not received anything. They have no ERA for the last 2 years. They have no PDA for the last 2 years. And I think the reason why I was appointed as caretaker was precisely to make sure that the requests of these barangays, of these communities that I visited, reach the national government, that are responded to by the government.
I guess the main issue here of the critics of this particular move of yours, really, stemming from two reasons rather. One is a lack of delicadeza, and the other is really it gave you undue advantage to serve the province and yet run in next year's elections. You're being an appointed caretaker now. Smacks of lack of delicadeza because you've decided to run in this year's midterm elections. What do you say to that?
So I don't think I should be prevented from, one, deciding to facilitate the delivery of all these projects to the province simply because I decided to run in the next year's election. I think I still have time to do my job during the 15th Congress, and that includes my work as a member of the 15th Congress, and at the same time, to make sure that the money that and the services and the projects that the people of Dinagat deserve reach the communities where they really wanted to have all these development projects. And the opportunities, I think, that came in my way because it's a midterm elections next year, it's incidental to what I am supposed to do as caretaker of the province.
Mm-hmm. Now, another question. I mean, this has been the campaign line of the president when he was campaigning, this talk about tuwid na daan. Do you think that this falls into the line of tuwid na daan of the palace?
Yeah, in the first place, the project that have been appointed, that has been identified, all are results of consultations in different barangays. These projects are all accounted for, and anyone can scrutinize and look into the details of how these monies will be spent. And second, I think what I did was to facilitate all of these projects to be delivered to the province, and whatever benefit that I may get, you know, when during campaign period or during election time, I think it's incidental to what will be the result of the projects that will be implemented in the provinces. A lot of these, most of these projects came from resolutions that were submitted by barangay officials. In fact, they committed that they themselves will be monitoring the implementation of these projects. We will be very transparent in making sure that up to the last centavo, these monies will be spent for the projects that were identified by the barangay. And I don't think that that should stop me from deciding to pursue my dream in going back home to my island to be participant in the realization of all our dreams, to take the steps towards a more developed province now that we are have won the case in the Supreme Court and are beginning to fulfill the dreams of all the people here to develop the island. And I think that should not prevent me from pursuing that dream also and to join the citizens of this province to work together for the development of our province.
Mm-hmm. Could someone else have run in your place as representative of Dinagat Island? I mean, were you the only choice, or did you feel that you were the only one fitted to run in the midterm elections as representative of Dinagat Island?
Yeah, I think we should also look at the context of the province. The situation here is not similar to other provinces. We know very well that the Ikleos have controlled the politics of the province, and it's not easy for anyone who would be interested in running for any position in the province to decide to run and expect that they will put up a good fight. That's why, and I don't also think that I am the only one who should be a candidate. And in fact, I thought about running not because I am the only qualified candidate, but because I also want to be a participant to the process of change in the island. And I think my experience in Congress and my experience as an Akbayan party list representative gave me the competency and the capacity to participate and to also consider myself a good candidate for the coming election.
Mm-hmm. I guess a lot of people are just questioning the recent turn of events, because anyone who knows you, Representative Bagao, would really know the true your true nature. And I guess a lot of people were just surprised that you made the decision to run despite the appointment that came six or four months prior to your decision, or a month prior to your decision to run.
I don't question the people, you know, questioning my decision to run. For me, this is also a learning experience. But at the same time, a providential situation. Doors have opened for me when I was given the opportunity to become a caretaker. And I have seen the situation of the province, talked to the people, relate with all their past experiences and their future dreams. And that encouraged me to think about also participating and becoming one of the leaders of the province. And I don't think anybody can be faulted with that. It's an opportunity that came in my way, an opportunity to be able to serve also, and to continue what I have been doing in other municipalities, especially in the municipality where I came from. So I never thought of it as a limitation or a problem when I decided to run. Mm.
All right. And I guess the people would have the final say come election day,
yes.
Correct?
Yes. Yes, of course, definitely. And I think one of my objectives also is to be able to present to people different choices and learned choices, informed choices, so that when elections come, they will be able to make the right choice for themselves and for the future of the province.
All right, Representative Kaka Bagao, representing Akbayan, of course. Thank you so much for joining us tonight. I truly appreciate it. Thanks.
Thank you so much.